welcome to episode number 2 on Uncut and Unedited. I have with me today Ms. Gul Panag. She's a Hindi film industry celebrity, also a very avid technologist. So Gul, welcome to my show.
Thank you very much.
It's going to be 5 questions, 10 minutes, uncut and unedited.
Okay.
So here's my first question. Being a celebrity, you know, with the film industry, plus you run an NGO, you do marathons, everything. How does technology help you, you know, with all this stuff?
I think it helps me integrate the different aspects of my life very seamlessly. There was a time when to be able to take pictures, put them up, impart whatever is a message that you want to give out to people, have a platform to give out, would have, you know, taken number of days to put all together. But today, I'm sitting here and we're connected in a space of 30 seconds with people who are literally halfway across the world. To me, that is the magic of technology. The fact that you can be with people of you know, in one place and yet be equally connected with people you're not physically with, but you're actually virtually with. So even though we have a tweet up here with about 12-13 people, but there are a lot more that we're actually connected to virtually, we're also pretty much here. So I think it's the integration that technology provides in my life that I really personally think is very, very important, because I'm always connected with people on mail. I'm not somebody who's really good at talking on the phone, which is why I need a battery pack for my my iPhone. And for me, it's really about being able to talk on mail with people. I do Messenger with all my friends. Work-wise also, I think I prefer to deal on mail.
Okay.
And I just recently got myself a scanner on the iPhone. So
okay.
I've been scanning things and, you know, doing stuff. So for me, you know, I think it's seamless. I had on the flight to Bangalore, I had a feedback to give Jet Airways.
Okay.
I wrote the paper version. Then I said, you know what, I'm going to scan this and make a PDF out of it.
Okay.
And send it to those guys in case these people here in flight don't give it, because that also happens. Okay. So, you know, I mean, that's the wonder of technology.
Okay. So, normally when you are out, maybe not on the shoot or maybe through this, what is one gadget that you just cannot live with it?
It's my iPhone for sure.
Okay.
Because it integrates so many things. I'm on mail. I'm an avid enthusiast of wanting to know where I am at any given point of time in a new city. So the GPS, Google Maps integration that the iPhone offers is fantastic. The camera is quite decent now in this edition.
Okay.
I also like my scanner. I mean, imagine having a scanner in your phone, which, and it's surprisingly good.
Okay.
And I think this is the one gadget that I can't leave home without. I just wish it had like a 10 megapixel camera.
Okay.
And I wouldn't mind paying a little bit more for that, but it would really make life much simpler.
Okay. Also, it would be very, very, you know, kind of, you know, curious to know, like, what are the kind of gadgets that you have with you? Like, you know, iPhone, for sure, I see it in your hand.
I have an iPad which was recently given to me, which I'm very excited about, and I'm going to go and, in fact, I just got it today.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to go and explore it tonight. I'm also extremely, I carry the Samsung Galaxy Tab around as well.
Oh, okay.
I think it's interesting to play with different interfaces, you know, even though this is an Apple operating system, but to actually, the tablet was my first Android exposure.
Okay.
So I thought it was quite interesting, and I can see why Android will one day annihilate the Apple operating system. It will in one day. There's no doubt about that.
Okay.
Only time to come. As soon as their apps catch up with the Apple apps, I'm sure it will really. But by then, the point is, Apple will change the game again. So that's the beauty. They've stayed ahead of competition, not by competing with competition, but by staying ahead of the game. Another gadget that I use effectively is something at home, actually.
Okay.
I have a pretty intense entertainment console at home. So there's an Xbox, there's a PS3, there's a Wii,
wow.
There's a home theater system,
okay.
There's now the Mac Mini,
oh, okay.
And of course the television and the DVD.
Okay.
So at one point, I had these 9 remotes lying on my coffee table.
Okay.
But getting the Logitech really made life so much simpler. In fact, the Logitech remote, the newest edition that I have now, actually even integrates the AC remote.
Wow.
So literally this one remote takes care of everything.
The whole
in the whole anything that requires remote access. In fact, I just got an application which makes my iPhone function as a universal remote. I think that is really cool. I use a walkie-talkie set at home, which is of course archaic in terms of technology, but very handy because my man Friday Saroj, now famous on Twitter, he keeps one and I keep one, and we have a range of about 2.5 kilometers. So many times I have something to say to him, and earlier it would always be a phone call. Acha, how Saroj, you remind me, I'm doing this tomorrow. So he keeps my social sort of calendar as well in terms of meetings and stuff, and he's responsible for pretty much everything that I do. He's actually my man Friday, my PA, all rolled into one. So now, I just tell him, Saroj, come in, ye karna hai. So, you know, I think the walkie-talkie set is something which is really part of me, although it's not majorly tech.
That's a whole lot of gadgets you have.
No, hardly. I think I'm trying to think of something more interesting that I have. I don't know if you can call the gorilla pod a gadget, but I think the supporting gadget. Very often, you can't take pictures of yourself. If you know, if two of you are going, you want you both of you in the picture as well. So the gorilla pod comes in really handy. It gets mounted on pretty much anything, and you can take pictures of yourself. I also have this thing called the Clocky.
Okay.
It's a clock which is modeled on the Sony Roli platform. Mm-hmm. Well, Sony Roli idea.
Okay.
It rings and runs away.
Wow.
So very often, a lot of us who have to wake up for work, if you don't want to wake up, you're like. So, you know, you want to hit the snooze button, but suddenly it has run away.
Okay.
So it's got these shock absorbing things, and it goes and hits the wall and comes back. So it's not like it goes and hits the wall and stops there.
Okay.
Very often you'll find it under your bed, so you'll have to get out of bed. And it makes my dog quite uncomfortable because it suddenly goes prowling all over him. But yeah, I think the Clocky is a great, great thing.
Okay, so now let's talk about something about the social network. I know for sure you're a very, very avid Twitter. So
yes.
How has Twitter changed your social life?
Well, I'm meeting a lot. I mean, the kind of people I'm meeting today, I would probably never have met if it weren't for Twitter. So I'm meeting a lot of interesting people. I've made some very interesting acquaintances and relationships thanks to Twitter over some time, over the last year and a half that I've been on. 2 years, actually, almost. I've been Twitter now. And I think more importantly, it gives someone like me an opportunity to speak my mind on various issues. What will typically happen with someone like a Bollywood actress is you don't get an opportunity to speak your mind about anything of relevance. You only ask for your opinion on, so, who's the hottest cricket star? So, who's the hottest actor? I don't want to talk about all that. I mean, there are not people who do that anyway. So, where do I put out my thoughts on, say, the traffic in Mumbai, or how dirty it is, and why nobody cares, and why somebody will drive in a 50 lakh car but still throw a plastic packet out of it. These are things we know but we don't speak about.
Okay.
Or how I think women are just unsafe in India, period. I don't think we can say with surety that Indian women are safe under Indian rules.
Yeah.
Apart from the fact they'll get run over and die. But even from a point of view of sexual safety, then I don't think women are safe. So where do you get opportunities to say all this? I think Twitter has done that. Also, it puts you in, over a period of time,
mm-hmm.
and this has been my opinion, you attract the kind of people you want to converse with.
Okay.
So I fortunately have a very intelligent, interesting Twitter community that we constantly discuss, debate issues, and it's quite an eye-opener sometimes. So many times my views, opinions and perspectives on things have changed thanks to Twitter.
Okay, last question. I know you run an NGO, so do you want to talk something about the NGO?
Well, being a celebrity, often NGOs will approach you and say, can you come to this event, can you come do this for us, because they have. Unfortunately, media in India doesn't cover any event unless and until it has some kind of famous face attending it. So I had a lot of people, and because I was socially conscious from a very young age, I had a lot of people requesting me to come to X, Y, Z. So I found that I was being pulled in all kinds of directions, from gender issues to AIDS to rights of the physically handicapped. And I felt that I needed to have my own identity in terms of what I stand for, the causes that I espouse. And I think it was very, very important, because if you speak up for everything, then when you really need to make a point, you won't be heard. So the Current Situation Foundation, which is powered by programs that Bill for Change runs, is essentially a platform to bring into contact people like myself who want to do something in society but don't know how, in touch with agencies that need people with expertise and desire and willingness to do something. So I still work with other NGOs, but now it is only do with the core issues that my foundation looks at. And we're hoping to come up with a path-breaking, incentivized volunteer system in the next couple of months that will encourage people to build empathy across society.
Okay.
So that's the plan.
Okay, thank you. So that's Gul for Change, right?
Yes. www.gul4change.com.
Okay. Gul, that's been a very good interview with you for the last 10 minutes. We hope you have a good stay in Bangalore.
Thank you.
Thank you.